One of the most important rooms of modern genetics is located right in New York City, but does anyone know where it is and who worked there?
The fly room was Morgan's lab at Columbia, which was absolutely packed with these fly bottles. Originally, the flies, I think, were brought to the lab through bananas, where they actually trapped them, and they fed them with the bananas. And now we keep them in bottles with jelly-like food on the bottom, and that's where they lay their eggs. Morgan and his students, Bridges and Sturtevant, they were interested in evolution and how genetic variation arose and drove speciation and those kind of questions, very basic, fundamental questions about evolution at the beginning of the last century. And so most of their experiments were really just breeding together different flies in a pretty large scale operation to get enough flies to actually identify particular mutants, because mutation is not a very frequent process. So their approach to it was just to grow a lot of flies. And that's why they chose flies, was how easy it was to rear them and the fact they have a very short generation time. That allowed them to get enough numbers to actually identify mutations. It turned out there were some fairly obvious things that you can see in a fly, like how their wings are shaped. Sometimes the wings can be curly or they can kind of be blistered. You can also identify a lot of mutants with eye color phenotypes. So having collected all these different mutants like wing and eye color and those kind of mutants, they then looked at the relationship of how those different mutants were inherited. These are the first genetic mapping experiments. You find that you can actually arrange the genes in kind of a linear order in a purely genetic map. And it turns out that that's one of the first pieces of evidence that genes were really on chromosomes. One of the mutants they identified was the white-eyed mutant, and that was inherited in a sex-linked way. So, the male would typically have white eyes, not the females. One of the things my lab is interested in is understanding what it means to form and recall a memory. We know what a lot of the genes are that are involved in the learning process in flies, and it turns out that many of those genes are also involved in learning in humans. A lot of people took flies as a great model system for studying development, right? Because you can follow the different stages of development of Drosophila.
So what happened to the fly room? Does it still exist? Some students from Brooklyn International High School headed to Columbia University in New York City to find out. So now they know the building still exists, but what has become of the fly room? If it's still there, what does it look like?
There's been a false wall put in between these two rooms, but that room and this room, I believe, were the fly room.
They found it. The fly room's now used as a prep lab for teaching undergraduate biology at Columbia.
There's a very, very big role for Columbia University in the origin of genetics and its application in particular to developmental biology.